If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance declaring war on the New World Order. TruthRadioShow.com. Shalom and welcome to the Dan Bedani Show at TruthRadioShow.com and welcome to the Book of Acts. We are now on Chapter 6. So if you missed Chapters 1 through 5, they're in our playlist. So please check them out. And again, welcome to the Book of Acts, Chapter 6, our in-depth, comprehensive study of the Bible. And we go chapter by chapter, and we do a specific Bible study approach for each or one of these shows. Number one is we pray for wisdom and understanding, so let's do that right now. So, Yeshua Jesus, we come before you and ask you to forgive us all of our individual trespasses, sins, abominations, or anything bad we might have done. We ask you to forgive us, Lord, and make us pure before the Father. And thank you, Jesus, for everything. Thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. And we ask you, Heavenly Father, to once again protect us all from the forces of evil and to help us understand your word and install upon us, Lord, the great comfort of the Holy Spirit to help write your word upon our hearts today in the book of Acts chapter 6. And we ask you in your mighty name, amen. So we do that, guys. We read the scripture in context, and because context is key, we demonstrated that at the last video, how important reading something in context is. And we let the scripture interpret scripture. Just when you don't think you understand something, keep reading. And it'll interpret itself, or the Holy Spirit will interpret it thereof for you. Real cool. It really is. It works all the time. So you got a Bible, guys. Turn to Acts chapter 6. And where we left off, Acts chapter 5. Was an awesome chapter, very awesome chapter, a lot of context in this chapter here. So the church that Peter was building, again, it's not the Catholic Church or nothing like that, it's not a religion. The church that the apostles were building was huge, getting huge, right? So once again, the priests, the Pharisees, you know, the top people in Israel, once again threatened the apostles. They told them to keep their mouth shut, don't preach about Jesus. And they were caught, and they did it anyway, and they were caught, and this time a lawyer saved them. And before they let them go, they beat the apostles up. Now, here's a cool thing about this, right? After they beat up the apostles, and they told them, you know, they threatened them, don't speak about Jesus again, right? The cool thing about it is, right, when they departed, right, they were rejoicing for him. Because they, like, wow, we are actually worthy enough to get our butts kicked for Jesus. That means we did our job. And like I mentioned in the message at the last show there, if you're getting persecuted for, you know, preaching the word of God and doing what you're doing for God, right, that means you're doing your job. You should rejoice then. Don't get discouraged from it. Heck, I have my YouTube channel deleted. Yeah, and that shows that the enemy is against you and you're doing your job. Don't get discouraged from it. Just rejoice from it. And what did they do after they got threatened to shut up, right? Yeah, they intensed their work afterwards. Right after they went from house to house this time, they went into temples and they ceased not. They didn't stop preaching the word of Jesus Christ. They kept going even more now. That's what people of God do. Well, left off the last chapter, people of God, when they get told to shut up, we speak louder. When we get threatened, we speak louder and harder. That's what people of God do because as Peter told these people there, we ought to obey God than men. When they were told to shut up and they were commanded to shut up about Jesus, and Peter told them, no, we obey God. We obey God, not man. Plain and simple. So now on to chapter 6. So, and in those days, when a number of the disciples there was multiplied, there arose a murmuring of the Grecians against the Hebrews because their widows were neglected in the daily ministration. So, yeah, the number of disciples was multiplied. In other words, like the church, okay, their church, I'm not talking about a religious church, I have to emphasize it all the time, the church that Jesus created, okay? It's not a Catholic church, it's not this church or that church, it's the church of God that Jesus created, right? They were expanding like beyond control. Beyond the control of the Jews, beyond control of the Romans. with their, you know, the Church of Rome at the time was all pagan, and it still is today. But I won't get into that, whatever the case. But yeah, so anyway, then the 12, which is the apostles, right, called the multitudes of the disciples onto them and said, it is not reason that we should leave the word of God and serve tables. So, yeah, there's no reason we should leave the word of God to serve tables. So this was getting huge, right? And we learned in the last chapter too, when they were gathering all these disciples, right? All the disciples, the people joining the apostles there, they were told to sell all your land, sell everything. And what they did is they sold everything they had and put it together into one fund. This way they could distribute amongst everybody and help each other and also help the needy and the poor. So the community itself had money. That's how they were able to survive and do things. So, wherefore, brethren, look at out among you seven men of honest report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business. So look out among you, you seven men of honest report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, and whom we may appoint over this business. But we will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word. So this is one massive ministry growing. This Church of Jesus Christ, yeah. And no, not the Mormons, the real Church of Jesus Christ. The people, it's not a religion or a building. It's a belief in Jesus. Like, I don't belong to any religion. I am a follower of Jesus Christ. That's what this ministry is. Ministry of the word, not a church or a building or anything like that. So, but we will give ourselves continually to prayer and to ministry of the word. And the saying pleased the whole multitude. So when they said this, right, we're going to continue to, you know, prayer. We're going to continue to do the ministry of God, right? So this pleased everybody. They're like, yeah, let's do this. And they chose Stephan, a man full of faith and the Holy Ghost, and Philip, and Prochorus, and Nicar, and Timon, and Parmenas, and Nicholas, a proselyte of Antioch. I hope I pronounced all that stuff right. If I didn't, I apologize. So these seven were chosen, right? The men of honest, right, report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom. So these seven men were chosen for this purpose, right? Whom they set before the apostles, and when they had prayed, they laid their hands on them. And the word of God increased, and the number of the disciples multiplied in Jerusalem greatly, and a great company of priests were obedient to the faith. So they're converting a lot of Jewish priests now, you know, which is not going to sit too well with the hierarchy of the Jewish, you know, faith, as we've seen in the last chapter. And Stephan, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people. And remember, these guys were ordained by the apostles with the power of Jesus Christ. Through the authority of Jesus Christ, I'm sorry. Then there arose a certain of the synagogue, which is called the synagogue of Libertinus, and Carians, and Alexandrians, and of them of Sicilia and of Asia, disputing with Stephen. So you had these people here disputing with Stephen. And they were not able to resist the wisdom and the spirit by which he spoke. Because remember, the spirit that's in wisdom coming from Stephan, or Stephen, I don't know, I hope I pronounced that right, I apologize, but that's the Holy Spirit speaking through Stephen. We'll just call him Stephen, how's that sound? Because I don't want to butcher anybody's name, so I probably did a bad job already doing that, so I apologize. So anyway, then they suborned men, which said, we have heard him speak blasphemous words against Moses and against God. So suborned, which I think is... It's lion, basically. Yeah, suborn is a past tense. Suborn, bribe or otherwise include someone to commit an unlawful act of perjury. Yeah, so basically they try to use perjury here. Then they you try to use perjury men here, which said, we have heard him speak blasphemy words against Moses and against God. So try to get people to lie to say they heard Stephen speak blasphemous against Moses and God. And they stirred up the people and the elders and the scribes and came upon them and caught him and brought him to the council. And set up a false witnesses, which said that this man ceased not to speak blasphemy words against the holy place and the law. For which we had heard him say that this Jesus of Nazareth shall destroy this place and shall change the customs which Moses delivered us. So, and all that sat in the council looked steadfastly on him and saw his face as it had been the face of an angel. All right, so, yeah, this is some serious stuff going on, right? So, Stephen, all right, and I apologize by butchering the name, call him Stefan. It might be Stefan, I don't know. But Stephen, all right, one of the most powerful ones of the seven here that they chose, right? Full of faith, power, and great wonders and miracles he did for people, right? So, of course, they attacked him, right? So they caused people to commit perjury against Stephen and the council. And when they brought him to the council, right? So he's sitting in the council here, right? And people are just looking at him. They're looking at him and saw his face as it had been the face of an angel. In other words, the radiance that was coming from his face. Because remember, it's not because of him. It's because he who is in him is greater than all the world, right? It was the Holy Ghost that's in him. I can't believe this chapter only has 15 verses. I didn't even notice that, guys. I apologize. So this might be a short video. So we can probably go over this again. So I like to take my time doing this. And I forgot this was only 15 verses. So I like to take my time doing this so we can have a great understanding of each chapter. Some chapters can go for 20 minutes, some can go for an hour. Depends on the context and the length of the chapter. So right now this is focusing on Stephen, right? So Stephen was one of the seven chosen. Out of the whole thousands of people, thousands of disciples, right? The Holy Spirit helped the apostles choose seven people that they may be able to heal people and everything else still, right? So they looked among the people, right? And they chose seven of the most honest report. In other words, people who were just stellar with the word, people who were honest and worthy, right? They were full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom and whom may appoint over the business. So in other words, who the apostles might point for them to continue what they're doing. But the apostles said, we're going to still continue in prayer and do the ministry, right? So, and these people were chosen, right? The list of people here. Stephen was the first one chosen. And obviously right now he's like, what I'm looking at, he's the most powerful person chosen, right? So they also were set before the apostles when they had prayed and laid their hands upon them. So basically they're anointing these seven people. So when the word of God increased and the numbers of disciples multiplied. So these guys were helping people all over the place and just bringing more and more people to the ministry. So it's with Stephen here, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among people. So now, of course, when the people from the synagogues and all these other people, right, that were against them, of course they're looking at Stephen now because Stephen's standing out amongst everybody. So that's why they went out and coerced people, a bunch of men, to commit perjury, to lie in court, basically, when they went to the council, to speak against Stephen, to lie and say that Stephen was speaking blasphemous words against Moses and God, right? And when he did this, it stirred up the people and the elders and the scribes, and all came upon him to court him and brought him to the council. So now he's sitting like this council in the court. If you want to call it, yeah, it would be a court, right, in today's world. So Stephen's sitting in court right now, right, before all the elders and all the bigwigs, right, of the Jewish faith, right? And, of course, there was false witnesses set up to testify against Stephen. And they all lied and said, this man sees not, that he, like he's continuously to speak blasphemous words against this holy place and the law. Lying about Stephen. Sworn witnesses. Right? That were sitting there lying. But false witnesses. Right? And then they all say, we all heard him say it. And that this is Jesus of Nazareth shall destroy this place and shall change the customs of Moses deliver us. So they're saying that Stephen's like saying that Jesus is going to destroy this whole place and we're going to change the customs of Moses and everything. To change everything, and he's speaking blasphemy against Moses and God. That's what they were lying before the council. So the whole council was sitting there, right? And when they looked at Stephen, they saw his face. It was lit up. Like radiance coming from his face, like an angel. So imagine the next chapter is going to be a continuation to this. And I apologize for the short chapter, but yeah, 17 minutes is not bad. So, you know, look over this. And now I can't wait to get to the next chapter because I can't wait to see what they say about this. Because I am sure, okay, that these elders, okay, these priests and all that, they want anybody that gets caught preaching the word of, you know, Jesus, yeah, they want them dead. And I'm sure they already had that mindset, and they, especially having liars to commit perjury against them. So does this lawyer from the last chapter, does this lawyer that came about to save the apostles, is he going to save him? Or is the Holy Spirit going to save him? Well, you know, what's going to happen? So that's going to remains to be seen in the next chapter. So amazing stuff, man. And I could, yeah, his face has been the face of an angel. So to me, that's probably a radiant, glowing face. And you got to remember, too, Stephen was full of the Holy Spirit. Awesome stuff. It really is. So we will see you for chapter 7. And thank you guys for tuning in. And again, sorry for a short chapter, but that's the way it is. So trust in the real plan, and it's the Bible. And don't take my word or anybody else's word for it. Read it for yourselves. Big important thing. Read it for yourselves. Very important. So check out our show, Spiritual Warfare Shows and everything else at truthradioshow.com. And we got a Bible series on there. And it links to our YouTube channels, our Rumble channel. And we always post the latest shows on the website. You can watch it right on the website, actually. And you can watch the Bible series right on the website. So if you actually go to the website right now, since we've got a little time here, we got a truthradioshow.com. Hope you got faster internet than this. If you go there, and right there is a Bible series. And we got Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and Acts now. So you click on the gospel you want, and there you go, chapter by chapter. I can't believe I got this far. I started off with the book of Jude. I didn't include that yet because I'm probably going to redo it. But I said, let's do Matthew. So we end up Mark, Luke, John. Now we're into Acts. I'm going to go right through. So awesome stuff. And we got the links to our shows as well. Spiritual Warfare Friday show we just had. Awesome stuff. You can actually watch it right on the website, yeah. Like, really cool. And it's the links to all of the brothers and sisters shows. Bible series, our documentaries, our sponsors, and all that good stuff. So check that out, guys. TruthRadioShow.com. And thank you for tuning in. And thank you for reading the book of Acts with us, chapter 6. We'll see you for chapter 7. God bless. Shalom. Remember, you are the resistance.